my first YouTube interview with Scott, who I met at Whole Foods the other day, who just returned, I think that same day, from where?
Hockford.
And I asked him if I can interview him because most of us don't have $7,000 to learn what Scott just learned. So what did you learn that helped me on my rocket diet?
I learned, number one, it's all about the raw food. Raw food has hormones, it has oxygen, it has phytonutrients, and it has enzymes in it. And when you cook the raw food, you kill it. So it makes that raw food dead food. And as a live body, we need live food. But if you eat dead food, our live bodies slowly become dead over time. Does that make sense?
Yeah, that's why I started the raw food diet. I feel so much better. Basically, I'm on it. The reason why I stay on it is because of how great my brain feels.
See, I didn't know when I first attended there, we had a meet and greet. We were in a big circle and everybody was explaining why we were there. So I just said, you know, I'm here. You know, I've been serving people for a long time. It's time for me to get quote unquote service.
Because you're a chiropractor, right?
Yeah.
So you've been taking care of patients.
A long time. So it's like, I felt like I was giving of myself so much. It's time for something to give me. But when we went around the room, everybody said they had this condition, and mostly a lot about cancers. And from what I was told, a lot of people feel it. The majority of people feel it.
Their bodies innately know how to heal, so you give them what? The tools.
Which is, fear, the knowledge. So they detox your body. That's all it is detoxing, getting all the crap out of your body, and putting the best nutrients in your body that this earth has to offer. And then your body heals. Everybody heals. That's it.
And one of the things that was like picking Scott's brain in the Whole Foods line, I was like, oh my God, you have to come and tell me everything. One of the things that my husband and I buy a lot of is raw cashews, because David loves raw cashews. And Scott said that wasn't ideal, and I was curious if you could say why.
Yeah, peanuts and cashews are horrible for you.
Why?
They have, number one, peanuts have it's called aflatoxin.
Aflatoxin,
it's called. It's a mold. And it's cancer causing. And then there's in cashews, there's a poison in cashews. Just like the poison in poison oak, poison ivy, it's the same class of poison. And the only way to extract the poison is by boiling it, making it, or somehow cooking it. So when you do that, you cook in oil, turns rancid, and all rancid oils cause cancer. Fish oil, cancer causing. You go get french fries at a restaurant, cancer causing. It's heated oil. And,
any kind of oil, even olive oil?
You can heat it up. The best organic olive oil in the world, you heat it up, it is cancer causing.
See, I didn't know that, but I'm not heating anything up anymore, but I bet most people don't know that.
Coconut oil, sesame oil, sesame oil.
What about if you put it in the dehydrator at one? Dehydrator goes up to 114 to 118, which is still allowed on the raw food diet. And some people put oil on their kale to make kale chips. What is the safety temperature?
115 is what they're advocating. If it doesn't go over 115, the nutrients are still there, the enzymes are still there, you don't kill it.
And what was your day like? You stayed there for a week?
You must specifically, my day or every day?
What was your day like on this, it was a 7-day retreat?
I was there for 3 weeks.
Yeah, what was that like? Give us a day there.
I was like, it's like a summer camp. I was like,
an adult summer camp.
My day, I can't talk to other people. My day was, I wake up and I go make wheatgrass. They tell you to take 2 ounces of wheatgrass in the morning, 2 at night. I was eating 9, I was drinking 9 ounces, 11 ounces. So I make my wheatgrass, work out, 30 minutes, 45 minutes in the infrared sauna.
Infrared sauna, what's that?
Yeah, it's a, you go to gyms and casinos, cruise ships, they have the hot saunas, the infrared sweat.
Yes.
This is infrared sauna. It's wavelength of the sun that is great for being toxified. You don't get to ultraviolet.
How did they produce that?
It's in a, they have, there's companies that sell it.
So it's like a light?
Yeah, well, it's a light, but you don't feel the, you don't feel light, you just feel the heat. So you sit in these saunas and you sweat, and you're sweating out the top, 80%, 85% of the sweat, being a sweat is all toxic.
Oh, yes. So besides sweating out, you know, fat crying is what I call sweating, it's really toxic,
toxic
crying.
Yeah, toxic. Eliminate the toxins from the cell. So I would do the sauna for 30 to 45 minutes, take a shower, go over to the hall, get my 32 ounces of nut milk, make me some tea.
What's the nut milk, Adam?
Nut milk, it's Brazil nuts and or almonds. They blend it up with water and they filter it out and just grab the nuts. Sometimes nice. I would have...
So is that, was that for your calcium or instant protein?
Because I didn't want to lose weight. Yeah. I was allowed the nuts and cereal and the breakfast. So I did that, made some tea, and then I went to the hot tub.
Just
herbal tea. Yeah, they had tons of herbal tea. So I made my lemon drink, lemon water. And then I either had classes to attend, I either worked getting some other form of exercise, like they had Pilates, they had Tai Chi. Qigong.
I love Qigong.
A couple of classes
moving
like that.
Energy. Show me a Qigong move.
I don't know what Qigong was.
Oh, that's my favorite.
I like this.
Right, help me get toxins out of me in a Qigong move. What would that look like?
When you're twisting.
Oh, really?
When you're twisting, you're like compressing the organs. And that was good for yoga. I love yoga. Yoga for time to me. And then at 10 o'clock, they had a green drink. So that's...
10 in the morning?
Yeah, 10 in the morning, 4 in the afternoon. They made a drink, green drink for me, which was made of sprouts, cucumbers, and one of the vegetables. So that keeps your body alkaline. And the more alkaline your body is, the more toxins are eliminated, and it decalcifies the entire body. So then 12:30 was lunch, and then after lunch, I went to the hot tub, cold tub, the Dead Sea salt pool. Supposed to do 7 cycles. Went to other classes. 4 o'clock, my green drink.
What were the classes on? What was your favorite class?
With Brian Clement. And we were talking about some questions and answers. You can ask me anything you want.
What was the most shocking thing you learned?
The fruit.
What did you learn about the fruit?
The fruit is such, there's such a high amount of sugar in fruit. It's been hybridized for the last 6,000 years, all fruit. So fruit has 50 to 70 times more sugar than it did the original fruit. And cancer or sugar feeds cancer. Any type of sugar. Actually, the cancer cell has insulin receptors on it where they crave the sugar from fruit more than the white sugar.
That's not things for
people. So everybody in there that had cancer or any type of condition, no fruit. No, you're not allowed any fruit. I could have fruit, but I chose not to.
That's really interesting because on the raw food diet, I love and I crave the greens and the vegetables. And then when I have too many grapes, I totally crash. I have this like blood sugar crash and I want to take a major nap. So I was like onto the fact that I had to limit it just intuitively. Like, my body was just crashing on that fruit. I mean, I still like my couple bowls of really small amounts of grapes, but too much, whoa.
You're pretty intuitive. But that was the main, I revolted with that idea for 2 weeks.
You're just like, because you're a big fruit eater, right?
I don't want to say a long, I was a decent fruit eater. And I love raw honey.
So, a bit of lemon raw honey, like two teaspoons of that.
Yeah, yeah. Stevia, the big component of stevia. So, fructose, the sugar from fruit, is like the most horrible thing to put in your body. That's what they found. And so I learned a lot about the sprouts. That was the mainstay. The mainstay of what we use is wheatgrass, sprouts, which are living food, which has electricity. Has all the other hormones, oxygen, vitamins,
They talked about food having electricity in it.
Oh, yeah. It's a very electric body. There's books on it. Our body's electric. When you eat the living sprout, it basically forced food.
So if you found this helpful, give us a thumbs up, right?